Hi everyone, Piet Kalemijn here. I hope you're having an awesome day. So what is the minimal setup that you need to do embedded hardware design? It's a question that I often get, and basically there's two types of answers that you can give. If you're doing very specialized stuff, of course you will need very specialized machines, but in most cases for people doing embedded hardware design, a very basic setup will be sufficient. There's ways to spend a lot of money on, for instance, the scopes that you see. There's cheap scopes, there's very expensive scopes, but the question you have to ask yourself is, what do you actually need? So in this video, I will dive a bit deeper in what you actually need, what a minimum viable setup is to do embedded electronics design, and you'll be surprised by the results. So let's dive into it. These are the basic tools, so 5 basic tools and an extra 6th one if you want. So first of all, power supply, powering your system in a reliable and controllable way. Of course, if you have a battery powered system in debugging, you want to power that with an existing power supply, not with the battery. To really see what is going on, you can apply the correct voltages there. You will see current through these kind of things. Oscilloscope, for me, this is the single most important asset in your lab, maybe after the power supply, because of course, without any power, there's no measuring. But if you are on a very tight budget, you need at least a scope. And there is relatively cheap scopes available these days, let's say from 150 euros and upwards. I will show you some choices in a bit, but this is the single most important asset in your lab. You will be able to measure voltage there, you will see the signals. There might be some logic analyzing even on board on your scope. So this is very interesting stuff and very necessary stuff for debugging. Then a handheld multimeter, thing that is a basic thing as well, to do in-circuit probing, soldering verification, resistance measurements, these kind of things. A tabletop multimeter, so next to the handheld multimeter, I would certainly recommend that as well. And that you will need to do accurate current readings or measurements, voltage measurements, power measurements, also resistance measurements. You can have the same things as on the handheld multimeter, so resistance measurements are possible with the tabletop as well. But especially the accurate power measurements are an important one in embedded hardware design, and that tabletop multimeter will enable you to measure up to 1 microamp. So again, for a relatively low price, that's an important tool and asset to have in your arsenal. Then a logic signal analyzer, debugging your firmware in an easy way, knowing what happens on your R2C, SPI, RS485, and so on lines. So this is a signal analyzer. So it's a piece of hardware used in conjunction with your computer and software on the computer. And it will act like a scope, but for the digital signals. So you will be able to probe your digital signals. You will be able to combine a few of these. So for instance, I2C, there's 2 lines, a clock line and a data line. And the software will already immediately calculate the data from that. So you don't see just the waveforms, you already see the data. So you see I2C addresses, acknowledges, this kind of thing. We'll discuss that in a minute. But again, for embedded hardware design, this is a very important tool to use. And then as an extra, let's say, it depends a bit how much you are doing analog design, but it is the use of a signal generator. So it's an interesting extra for analog setup debugging. You're able to apply certain kinds of waveforms like sine waves, pulse waves, square waves, what have you. This could be interesting for some specific circuits, but it depends a bit on your needs. I don't see it as an immediate necessary thing to have, but if you have a lot of circuits where you need to apply these kind of signals, then for a relatively low cost, you can add that to your tools as well. So maybe a bit more in detail then, power supplies. On the left-hand side, you have a simple model, and this is already more than sufficient. I would say if you can accurately set the voltage, and maybe this is now on hundreds of volts that you can set it. Maybe it's interesting to even set it on tens of millivolts. So it depends a bit. The higher the resolution, of course, the more expensive that the supply will be. So on the left-hand side, that's a cheap one. On the right-hand side, that's another ballpark figure that you would pay for that. For simple debugging, of course, the left-hand is already sufficient. Then a scope, starting around 300 euros, let's say, for the 4-channel ones. I would recommend to try and go for a 4-channel scope, because that gives you flexibility. Of course, with scopes, the sky is the limit. On the left-hand side, there's a very good scope that you can use. You have four channels, you have a lot of logic analyzing possibilities already on board. There's measuring systems on there. You can make pictures of this, print them out, put them on USB. So a lot of stuff there for less than 400 euros in that case. The right-hand side, that is of course another ballpark figure. I think it's times 10 and even more. Of course, yeah, there's, that's a full-fledged scope. Sky's the limit. If you want a minimal setup, the left-hand side should do it for embedded hardware design. And again, if you need that specific stuff, like I see that there is a spectrum analyzer on there included in that scope, it would be interesting to contact an expert for that and use their equipment if that is a one-off. If you are constantly doing RF design, of course, then it might be worth considering buying that equipment. Handheld multimeters, again, there's simple models from 50 euros, maybe even less than 50 euros and upwards, and then you can go up to 1,000 euros as well for a very dedicated multimeter. The choice is up to you. Again, it depends a bit on the resolution that you want to achieve, but typically the low-cost models, they are more than sufficient for what you want to do. You want to verify your soldering, your circuit, do some resistance measurements. So if you have sufficient resolution there, that is more than sufficient. Tabletop multimeter, exactly the same story. So from the prices here are from 150 euros and up. The most interesting thing you can do with these is measuring low currents, so in the ranges of microamps. And the question there is, what resolution do you want to achieve? And do you want higher resolution, then the price will increase. Do you need more channels? This kind of things. So again, there's a choice between the cheap alternatives and the very expensive alternatives. It depends on your needs. But the left-hand alternative will already be very good for a lot of debugging. Then logic signal analyzer. So from 25 euros onwards. So you can buy the, so on the left-hand side on the top, that's a 25 euro logic analyzer. Very cheap stuff, but it could do the trick. My recommendation here, because you are embedded hardware designer, that would be to go for a more pro model. And this pro model will not cost you 1,000 euro, but it will be around 300 or 400 euros. I like to use the Sally-i for that, and it will save you a tremendous lot of time. So there is a small video on their website to indicate a bit what is happening. So what you do here is that software that is running on your computer, you hook up the Sally-i to your system, and then you will sample what is happening. And you can trigger the samples. So if, for instance, on an I2C line, you see the line going low, then the system will start triggering and sampling. So what you see over here is there is two channels that are sampled. There is an SCL and SDA. And the interesting thing is that you can decode the protocol immediately again. So we'll wait just one more time here. So you see the decoding. So there's a setup write to, there's an acknowledge, there's no acknowledge, setup read to. So you know what registers you're writing to, reading to, you see addresses. So very quickly, you know what is happening on your I2C bus. You can decode other protocols as well, just serial protocols, Modbus protocols. So there's a lot more in there, SPI. So I suggest you to look into these kind of options. This will save you a tremendous lot of time. Then, so as a supposed extra or proposed extra as a signal generator, again, I think for most of the debugging and testing, the 200 euro variant will be sufficient for you. You can go up to much more. You have the Roland Schwarz on the right-hand side, which has a lot of other functionality that you typically will not use in standard embedded hardware design. But you see the differences there. Now, I made the calculations for you for a minimal setup. So a power supply, I found a relatively good one for 150 euros. A good scope, I think that's the one that you have seen in the picture, the Regal one, for around 400 euros. Handheld multimeter, somewhere in between of 100 euros. A tabletop for 150. And then the logic signal analyzer, so that's the Sally-i, the 8 channel, you have it for 340 euros. So if you add that up, let's say the minimal stuff, you have 1140 euros for that. If you include the signal generator, a good one, I think it's even a Regal one that I have used here, the 240, you end up somewhere around 1400 euros. So to give you an idea what that would cost. Of course, if you don't need everything right away, you can buy it in batches. But this would be for me the minimal investment to make in your debugging setup. So I hope you liked that video. Of course, as always, if you have any questions, feel free to put them below in the comments. We can always discuss machinery. If you have a certain scope in mind but you're not sure, just put it in the comments. Let's look at it together and see if it fits your needs. I hope you got some value out of it. If you liked the video, don't forget to give it a like if you wish. And if you like the channel, of course, feel free to subscribe. Have a nice day and good luck with your minimal viable setup. Bye-bye.